My name is Mercedes, for those of you who don't know. Typically, I do mom vlogs, cooking vlogs, life advice, and things like that. I've been studying credit repair for about a year now. Well, a little over a year, honestly. And I've been doing disputes and things like that on my own credit and a few family members close to me. And I've been seeing a lot of great progress with some techniques that I'm gonna share with you all. So today's video is gonna be about cleaning up your profile and just giving you a few tips. I'm not gonna dive too deep into this video because I wanna keep it short. And the things that I talk about, I want to create a separate video for each topic. So I'm just gonna break it down into 1, 2, 3, 4 sections in this video. So let's get started. So the first section, your personal information. You need to go through and look through your personal information and look at the way they spell your name. You need to make sure they have the correct name. You need to make sure that the address that they have is the most current and the accurate address. And any other old addresses, you need to make sure those are deleted and removed from your credit reports. A lot of times addresses tend to link and connect with debt that you have on your credit report. So let's say you have a closed account, a charged off account, or something like that. Let's say you want to dispute that charged off account. Well, the credit bureaus will say that the account was verified just because it's simply linked to an address that's on your credit report. And they may say, yeah, they contacted the furnisher and they said that the information was correct. But 9 times out of 10, it's honestly because the information is linked to something in your personal information. Okay. So that goes for phone numbers and employers, as well as like your date of birth. I recently was checking my Experian credit report and I noticed that the last 4 digits of a social security number wasn't even mine. So I definitely had to dispute that, because what if some accounts that weren't mine were tied to that social security number? You know what I'm saying? Like, you have to pay attention to the things that are on your credit report, and the personal information section is extremely important. So when you look at your credit report, don't be so quick to just say, okay, whatever, they misspelled my name wrong, off by a letter, yada, yada, yada. No, your name is not spelled that way. You know, they need to have the information exactly like it is on your birth certificate, on your driver's license. Like, everything needs to match. Otherwise, who is this person? Because that's not me. You know, so just eliminating identity theft and things like that, and just also cleaning up your report. So definitely look through your personal information section and clear that up. One name, one address, your correct date of birth, correct social security number, and your most up-to-date accurate phone number. That's the only thing that should be there. All right, got it? Cool. Okay, so the second thing that you will see on your credit report will be inquiries. Now, inquiries don't typically have an effect on your credit after 12 months. They expire after two years anyway, so inquiries really aren't a big deal, but I will say it's good to keep the inquiries down to a minimum. After so many inquiries, it does start to affect your credit, and also it doesn't look too good if you are applying for credit or loans or things like that. It doesn't look good to the lenders. It also pulls at your credit. So every time you go to apply for a credit card or a loan, you know, a lot of times those are hard inquiries, which will knock your credit score down. So you just want to monitor those. And the best way to remove inquiries off your credit report, it would be smarter to contact them directly, opposed to going through the credit bureaus and saying, hey, I didn't do this, because all the credit bureaus are going to tell you is, yes, you did, you know. So just to eliminate unnecessary postage and paper wasted by mailing the credit bureaus, sometimes it works. I'm not gonna lie, sometimes you can write the credit bureaus and say, hey, I didn't apply for this credit and I didn't authorize it either, delete this from my credit report. Sometimes it will work. Sometimes you can make a phone call and get inquiries removed. Just take time out of your day, devote maybe an hour, 30 minutes to an hour, to contact each of the credit bureaus by phone and just say, hey, there are some inquiries on my credit report. I didn't authorize these. I need these removed. And you may get a credit customer service representative who is, you know, willing to help you. But then sometimes you may get old Stifler who don't want to help. So to eliminate that frustration, if you just want to go to the creditors directly, I would advise it. Okay, let's say you're skimming through your credit report and you notice that there are some missed payments, some late payments on your Capital One account. And You know that you fell on hard times during those times. Now, keep in mind, it's only 2 missed payments, okay? Not 15. Now, if you got 15 missed payments, we'll talk about that in another video. So let's say you have an open Capital One account and you have 2 missed payments. What I would suggest and what I've seen is working is a goodwill letter. Now, if you're gonna do a goodwill letter, you cannot go and dispute this account with the credit bureaus, because with a goodwill letter, you're basically saying, yes, I was late and I'm seeking some type of sympathy from you to remove these late payments, because since I've been late, since the last time I was late, I have been making nothing but on-time payments consecutively. And this is like being truthful now. Like, once you've noticed that, okay, hey, I missed 2 payments or whatever, it was because, you know, I fell on hard times. Maybe I wasn't getting enough hours, or I was out of work or something like that. But since then, I've been making payments on time ever since then, and I've been making more. Just say that in your goodwill letter. Like, open the goodwill letter by thanking them and letting them know, hey, I've been a customer for this amount of time. I've had an excellent relationship with you all. Basically a little butt kissing, but not too much. You know, you don't want to be all up in there, but basically just show them that you appreciate them. You've had a good relationship with them. And then, so stroke the ego first, and then you're going to let them know that, hey, I'm inquiring about getting 2 missed payments removed. This is what was going on during that time. And, you know, I would like to show you, like, I've proven since then that I'm worthy of making payments on time, yada, yada, yada. And basically, you're going to ask them if they could, you know, give you a second chance at a positive credit rating by removing the late payments off your credit report. And then you just thank them. Now, you can do this one of 2 ways. You can email the CEO, or you could just mail in a letter. Moving on to the 4th topic or section or whatever. So you have your collections, your charge-offs, bankruptcies, closed accounts, and like repos. So with this, with collections, we all know that you're not supposed to pay collections. At least that's what everyone says. And I'm gonna agree with that to a certain extent. Sometimes, depending on the company, if you choose not to pay the collection, then some companies will sue. I'm not going to say any names, but there are some companies who are known, who have a reputation for suing and are very aggressive. And it doesn't matter how much, you know, how much or how little the balance is, they will sue. So with collections, as soon as you get a collection letter in the mail, do not throw it away. Do not be afraid. I feel like that's the main thing, is people are afraid of collections. Like, they're only informing you of what's to come, and you still have 30 days once you get that letter to respond. And a lot of times we don't respond. So even on the letter, it says, if you don't respond, we're going to assume that the debt is yours. So what you would do in that situation, once you receive a collection letter, is to send off a debt validation letter. You don't have to find or get some fancy template for a dispute letter. You're simply writing them asking, what proof do you have that this is my debt? Do you have any letter, written letters with my signature on it? What ties me to you? Why do I have to pay you? I never signed a contract with you. A lot of times they don't even have all the information. They're basically just buying pieces of your information. And if they send you a bill in the mail, that's not any proof. They sent you something that anybody could find. Like, a bill is not a solid proof of debt. So you need something bearing your signature that ties you to that company. And if they can't provide that to you within the time frame, they have to cease collection activities and remove that account off your credit. Simple as that. And check the statute of limitations, the SOL. Basically, what this is a certain time frame where companies can sue you or take you to court or get a judgment out against you, things like that. So in the state where I did live, where the majority of my debt was from, is Mississippi. And Mississippi's statute of limitations is 3 years. So that would be 3 years from the date the account first went delinquent. So a lot of my accounts are past the 3-year mark. So if I chose to dispute those accounts, no one could come after me to sue me or something like that, you know? So you definitely want to be mindful of that before you go disputing accounts, especially accounts that are sleep, which would typically be your charge off closed accounts, because you don't want to wake a sleeping giant. So you don't want to dispute an account that is still within the statute of limitations for your state, or they will sue you. Also with charge offs, closed accounts, and bankruptcies, after you find out the statute of limitations, you definitely want to start looking for inaccuracies across the board, meaning through Experian, TransUnion, and Equifax. You want to make sure that everything matches. Everything must be the same. So I would suggest getting a tri-merged credit report, something like Smart Credit. Experian has it too. Identity IQ and Privacy Guard. That way you can see all of them side by side, and it's easier to compare the differences. So with bankruptcies, I'm actually going to make a video separate for bankruptcies, because there are some steps that I feel like you need to know that you could take to get bankruptcies removed from your credit report. But yeah, that I'm just going to end the video here, because like I said, I didn't want to make the video too long. So with those things, I hope that it did help you. If you do have any questions, definitely drop them down below. And like I said, I will make a separate video for like each topic. Today, I just wanted to give you like a general idea of what you can do to clean up your credit report. And I hope that that helps somebody. So if you enjoyed this video, definitely give it a thumbs up. Give me some feedback. If there's anything you want me to elaborate more on, let me know. Definitely go ahead and hit that subscribe button and tune in later for the bankruptcy video. All right? Y'all have a good day.